Hi everyone, this short video is going to show you how to download the federal client tool so that you can get the data entry tool and enter your NFIRS reports using the free software provided by the U.S. Fire Administration. You should already have a login before you try to do this step. You can't just download the software. You do need to get that login from your state program manager. Obviously, Kansas Fire Departments, if you're watching this, you should have gotten a login from me first. If you don't have it, contact me and I'll get you set up. Once you have your login, you can go to the website. It's nfirs.fema.gov. Once you come here, click on User section. And when it will load, come to the left and click on User Home. You would log in here. Once you're logged in, you should get to the site that says you're processing classified information. Continue. This is the login page. Go to the left and click Download Software. Now, this is the page for the NFIRS 5.0 software version 5.9.6. This is what you should see. You may need to scroll down, you may not. My resolution is a little different because I'm on a laptop. Scroll down until you see Download NFIRS 5.0 Client Version 5.9.6. And we're going to click on that link. It's going to bring you to this window here, and you're going to click on Download Now. If it gives you a choice on where to save it, I would save it to your desktop because it's the easiest place to get to. If it doesn't give you a choice, it will just download automatically to the folder for your downloads. I've already downloaded the executable here, so I'm just going to come over, and it looks like this. So if you have a lot of downloads, it is an icon that looks just like this. I'm going to double click on it, and then I'm going to click run, minimize this here. It's going to run for a few seconds. Eventually you'll get a window that will open up, welcome to the NFIRS data entry tool setup wizard. Just click next for everything. I accept the agreement, next, I accept, next. Don't change anything, just go typical installation, next, next, install. So I didn't change any of the settings, I just went straight through, I accepted everything and went forward. I'm going to let this run, it goes through pretty quickly. And you're done. I'm going to hit finish. It brings up a notepad here that you just close. Now it's installed, but it will not let you actually open it, and I'll show you what I mean. If you go to Start All Programs, you will now have NFIRS 5.9.6 in your list of programs. I add an icon to my desktop, so what I do is take Data Entry Tool and I create a shortcut for it, which I usually just drag it right to my desktop here. If I were to double click on this right now, it will just flash that black screen and then go away. So I'll show you one more time and see how it went away. To get rid of that, we have to do an extra security setting. And to get to that security setting, we need to click on the Start button down here and click on Computer. You may have Computer on your desktop already, so just click on Computer. Double click on your OSC hard drive and find the folder for Program Files x86. And if you need to pause the video as we go through while you're locating, feel free to do that. So I'm going to double click on Program Files x86. You'll have a list of folders. You may need to sort by the name in order to get them in alphabetical order. We're looking for NFIRS v596. We don't want to double click on it. We actually don't even want to left click. We want to right click until we get the submenu and choose properties. It's going to bring up this window and we want to choose security. Now this will only work if you're logged in as an administrator on the computer. So if it won't let you get this far, you may need to back out of it and get somebody who is an administrator. Once you get to the security tab, click on the edit button. Find the line that starts with users. Click on it until it's highlighted. And then down below, we're going to check the box for full control under allow. Click Apply, OK, OK, Close, and now we'll double click, and you should get this screen. This means that you're ready to go and your installation was successful.